see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Good morning, I'm Andrew.
And I'm Carson.
Today's date is Monday, October 15, 2012.
The weather today will be a high of 74 and a low of 60 with partly cloudy skies.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the singing of Yankee Doodle.
Next, we will pause for a moment of silent reflection.
Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now to our interviewers, Zach and Joshua, and our special guest, Mr. Singer.
Hi, I'm Zach.
I'm Joshua.
And this is Mr. Singer.
Happy Monday, everyone. You want to go ahead and start with our lunch menu?
Yes, sir.
Good deal.
Choice of one, cheese sticks with savory marinara sauce, grilled tilapia sandwich, grilled chicken salad meal, choice of two vegetables, sweet potato fries, seasoned green beans, romaine garden salad, choice of one fruit, fresh and canned fruit.
All right, thank you. And remember, as you're making your lunch selections this morning, make sure that you choose both a fruit and a vegetable in order to get a complete meal. Make sure that you observe the first 10 minutes of silence, making sure that you get everything you need in what?
One
1 bill.
Awesome, you remember, good deal. Enjoy your meal, and then once you're done, take your tray to the receiving line. We want to make sure that we don't have a lot of traffic on either the entrance or the exit of the lunchroom. Please remember in the afternoon to make sure that you're listening for your carpool number and station. It's important that you listen for your carpool number and station because we want to make sure that we do our job of making sure that you get home safely. But you have a part in that as well. You have to meet us halfway by listening for your number and station. And if you need assistance, ask one of the adults in the gym or throughout the breezeway or at the carpool lane. Anything else that you need assistance with carpool, just let us know. We'll be happy to help. We have a wondrous word today. Josh, you want to hold my wondrous word for me?
Sure.
I don't even have it. Okay. The wondrous word is?
Dissolve.
Dissolve. Dissolve. The wondrous word came to us courtesy of Jordan, third grader in Ms. Giles' class. Found the word dissolve in a book entitled Animorphs. Found the word in the following sentence. I began the process that would dissolve my bones. I began the process that would dissolve my bones. Have you ever heard of Animorphs before?
No.
I began the process that would dissolve my bones. I'm wondering, because the title of the book is Animorph, and it has morph in there, and I know morph means to change. I wonder if I began the process that would dissolve my bones. I wonder if whoever this is in the character in the book, if they're trying to change themselves or modify themselves in some way, transform themselves. I think that has something to do with that series. I'm not sure. I have to check it out. Okay, the way the word is used, Jordan believes that dissolve means to change. At the bottom, it says, thank you for sharing your wondrous word. Jordan wrote, you are welcome. So thank you for that. Fair play. Dissolve means... Let's use this one. To fade away as if breaking up or melting. To fade away. Let's just use to fade away. So if we use that in the sentence, began the process that would fade away my bones or dissolve my bones. That would make sense, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. Okay, so now it makes me wonder why this character wants to dissolve his or her bones and what was going on in the story that made them come to that decision. So, good job. Keep the wondrous words coming. And dissolve, I just thought about it. I made a connection, another connection. Dissolve my bones. Bones, what season is it?
Fall.
And what happens in October?
Halloween.
Halloween, and during that day or during that night, people dress up sometimes as?
Skeletons.
And skeletons are composed of?
Bones.
Just saying. Anyway, keep the wondrous words coming. I think that is why I chose that one. Keep the wondrous words coming. Have a great Gator Day. Anything you want to add, guys?
And to our anchors,
have a great Gator Day. Bye.